Well, my name is Fasiu John, and I come from a small island north of Fiji. I've had a very interesting and a varied career. I've served as a reserve military officer. I'm a lieutenant colonel. I served with the United Nations, and, you know, all the troubled spots in the world. So, you know, I've seen the best of life and I've seen the worst of life. And I moved here to Australia in 2015. My plan was basically to come and work for 10 years and then buy myself a fishing boat and go back to the island. I have a house built there already, so that was the plan. I arrived here June the 6th. I started working at Jerigong, getting a hotel up and running, and I only worked for 3 weeks. I was coming back one morning after deep in the pool. I thought I'll go and try and see how cold it is, and came back. So I was so cold that I had to run back. So when I ran back to my apartment, turning in, I kicked the curb. I took my shoe off. I kicked the curb and I had a little scratch. And within half an hour, when I came out of the shower, my leg was all blue, my left leg. And you know, I went to the doctor, which was in front of the hotel. And I said, "Doc, can you have a look at this?" And he said, "Oh, damn, you're in deep trouble." So he said, "You take a seat and I'll call the ambulance." And from there, I was taken to Shell Harbour Hospital. The surgeon looked at me and said, "You should be dead." I said, "Well, what choice do you have?" And he said, "My best choice is to take your leg off." And I said, "Okay, go for it." I came out, and then the social worker there sort of said, "Look, I'll try and tie you into a social housing, but don't raise your hopes because it's going to take 5 to 7 years. After 6 months, I went to Fig Tree for a haircut, and then I got a call from Housing Trust to say that, you know, there's a unit available and if I want to come and have a look at it. And oh, I thought that day it was God sent, because I didn't have my haircut. I just got into the taxi and came to meet the Housing Trust lady here. And when I came up to this unit, you know, just to see the bathroom that's specifically designed for my disability was something that I had. So when she said, "Do you like it?" I said, "You know, that's an understatement. I'll take it." So that made a huge difference. Getting this unit completely changed. I was able to be, you know, to move around better. Slowly I built this place up, and, you know, it's now my home. And, you know, I'm really happy with it. It has allowed me to bounce back, to get as normal as I can. And I can't thank Housing Trust enough for that opportunity. And looking back, I think the service that they provide is fantastic for people like us, who need a second shot at life and the ability to have the facilities to achieve what we want to achieve. As you see today, I'm walking with my prosthetic legs. I've been accepted for the next Paralympic Games, so, you know, that's another chapter that I'm going to work with. Things happen, you know. Some of us, you know, you never expect it. It's just out of the blue it comes, but it's how you take it. It's how you bounce back. But I tell everyone that, I say, look, if you come out alive, then you have a chance at getting a second shot at life. Don't blow it. That's what I've learned. My reason for doing the Olympic Games is to say thank you to Australia, because what I've been treated, I can't thank you enough. And if I can win a gold medal in the Paralympic Games to list Australia, that's my aim.